Hey guys, GoldenStar555 here, back with another video.
Entirely carbon dioxide, which isn't exactly breathable even to a jetpack. So Mustafar, as shown in the movies, just doesn't really make any sense. So Lucia is a planet that briefly features an ethereal free, but is completely distinct from the other being a multi-colored jungle of communities. The planet itself is a bit more than the Earth, and it's on the surface of the Earth. This would help the planet to grow greater sizes, and apart from the colour, which is pretty similar to Earth during the Cambrian, about 500 million years ago. So assuming the atmosphere of Lucia can mix nutrients and water around the planet with strong circulation, it could expand.
Two countries resemble the Earth might look like in the future, of course, and probably in common. Both these densely populated planets are about the same size as Earth. Coruscant's actually listed on Wikipedia as having a population of 1 trillion beings, and judging by the city shown in the film, this also seems about right for Hobbit and the Crown. The issue here is that Earth, with a population of just 7 billion people, is becoming hotter and hotter with available gases like carbon dioxide and methane and atmosphere. The effect of 1 trillion people on a billion sized planet growing power industry would be absolutely absurd. So either Coruscant or Hobbit and the Crown are doing superior human engineering, or impossibly, given the technology of the world, or they should be substantially better than they're shown to be. So there you get a mate. A planet with a similar issue is Phoebe, which is shown to have a dense planet in storms. Water vapor is actually a tremendously powerful greenhouse gas, strongly absorbing thermal wavelengths of radiation.